Hey guys, this is JLindseyB. I'm going to show you some stuff. Now I know this video is kind of late. I mean, I tried to get it ready before the year ended, but I kind of ran out of time. I mean, at the last month I was in the middle of this big move from one town to the other, so now I'm done. So, let's get started. Now you're probably wondering why I've never shown my face till now. Well, I like to keep a little bit private, but at this point, there is no privacy left in the world. So why not show my face? Here it is. Are you good? Are you good? And for the one person who said he didn't want to see my face, this is all I can give you. It's just... Are you good? You can see my shoulder, right? Okay, so anyway. So basically what I'm going to do in this video is a couple of deviants on DeviantArt. One, some just basic tips on how to do digital art, and I'm going to try my darndest to help you out there. I'm still learning myself. Technically, I have only been doing this for about maybe 2-3 years at tops. I mean, I've always drawn my entire life, but only seriously the past couple years I've been doing this. So basically, it's all still new to me, but I will try my best. Let's see here. Fiery Red Dog Techo wants some tips for drawing hands and feet. My brain stopped for a moment. That is one of the hardest things for an artist that I've learned, is the hands and feet. I guess what it is that we look at them all the time, and we just take them for granted that like they're just easy to draw or something. They're not. I personally have spent an hours on end trying to get just the hand on a drawing. I could like finish the whole drawing in like 12 minutes. So I'll spend 2-3 hours on hands and the feet. So anyway, I will try to explain that the best I can, Fire Red Dog Techo, which you guys can, who are watching, you can find his link down over here. Over here. Go to this one right here. And I'll start on that. So let me open up my Photoshop program, go switch to screen capture, and we'll see if I can help you out with anything like that. Well, I went ahead and drew a couple things before so where you wouldn't have to sit in this video for about 2 hours while I try to draw these hands. And I'm basically just going to give you a good lesson, just how I usually do it. One good way is by reference. Like right here is a reference I did of my own hand doing a llama. See? Llama. And that is one of the ways. It is for first-time starters, is to just look at your own hands and come up with stuff like that. After a while, you kind of get a feel for what they are, and you can do them without references as much. But to start a good, if you don't want to do references, you can do it like this way. Like, here's my starter hand. What you can do is, let me get a red color here. The hand is basically broken up into different shapes. You can either do a square shape, or you can do an oval triangle shape, and that will usually take care of the palm of the hand. You figure out where the muscles in your hands are by looking at your own hand, but normally is you can do a circle where your thumb joint is, and circles for where your fingers are starting. Now another good thing is, before you add your fingers, is you need to figure out your range of motion. How are you going to have your hands? Are you going to have them bent like this? Are you going to have them going forward? Because here's another good example. Basically, you've got your same oval triangle shape here, but here we have it differently. So we've got our circles here with our thumb circle down there. But anyway, a good way to start out is your range of motion, which is usually, if you spread out your fingers, it's how far you can spread them out, which they can go out pretty much that far unless you have a character that has the ability to do this. And I hope he has that ability, he or she has that ability, or else that would be painful. But anyway, range of motion helps that way, to where you can see how far your fingers can go. Now, most fingers is they won't be straight across. If you look at your own hand, you can see how they each have a curve. So it's like it curves up to the middle finger and then curves back down. But most of the time, it's the highest. It goes from slightly low to high to really low. So this is kind of the shape you want for your hands right here. The thumb has always been a tricky part for me. Normally, it's just you go out from the circle one line, two line, and circle in. Now, that's not the most technical way to do it, and there are much better ways because, of course, the thumb, even though it looks like it only has a few joints, it really has three joints in it starting here. And then there's a second one, kind of like something like this. And then your third joint is inside your hand right here. So here's are your joints. Now most of the time you'll only see the two joints because this is where your wrist is. But to me it sometimes helps to remember that. Anyway, moving on to feet. Feet are a different story. Feet are usually always just one big triangle. Like, see here, put that back on. See, I have this triangle set. Normally, you can just do a flat triangle, but with three-dimensional objects, I like to add a little bit down there. It usually helps because it helps you think about how it works. Because normally, when you look at a foot, when it does the foreshortening, it always looks like a triangle with your toes often right here. You've got your big toe here, and the little ones kind of fit in, and then everything else kind of just curves up to your ankles. Now, the foot is often curved a little bit itself. So once you get your basic shape, you can work on toes. And then your ankle kind of just goes inside. And then if you're at a certain angle, you can also add your heel. But that kind of looks like a really weird flat foot thing, and your heel would probably be down there. I'm better at anthrofeet, which I still need a little bit more practice. Like, see here, it looks like his toes are curling up, which is basically the same principle as a human foot. But instead of having to worry about all those little toes, you can pretty much just do... big toes, about four of them, depending on your critter. Like, here's my average fox foot that I usually do, which fox feet are a little bit smaller. So you've got pretty much your four toes there, and it pretty much just curves towards the side. Now, you can also have your anthrofeet just like a human foot. Like, here's a good example of a human foot. You got your pinky toe and your shape. So what you do is you just... add your toes to the side of that and add a little padding there, and then voila. Or you can also do the extra ankle foot thingy. I've got to get a thesaurus and speak correctly. But basically, it's your average dog foot. You got your paw, and then the rest of the foot is elevated off the ground. But most feet are often this triangular shape. If you start out any shape with the triangles, you can get a good idea of how your feet will go. But there are many other tutorials that you can look up on DeviantArt that would help y'all, but I hope this at least gives you a good idea of some of the things.
So the next thing that we're going to do is we have a comment from Jolton Thunderhead of DeviantArt. His comment reads, "I personally have no idea what to do when it comes to digital art, and it would be cool if you showed some basic starting tips." Trust me, Jolton, I have been there. I have been where it's like, what can I do to make this look better and everything? I mean, if you look in my gallery and find some of the old stuff, it's like, that's just some of the, no, get rid of it, no. Okay, anyway, so I'll pull up my Photoshop program and I'll try to work on some stuff for you and maybe give you a good idea for layers and stuff. What I use is Photoshop CS6. Now, you may use Sai or Open Canvas are another good programs to use. Or just simple MS Paint. Most of my early stuff was just done with MS Paint. It's just the great starting point of all digital artists. So I will get to that. Oh, by the way, you guys can find Jolton Thunderhead's account. He's up here. So you can click that and check out some of his stuff. All right, so let's get started.
One of the main things is first kind of visualize what you want. And there's many different ways to start something. For instance, me personally, I usually start with something simple. I'll start with like the eyes or something. Get it small enough to work. And usually, I'll just start from the eyes and work my way out. And you just keep working your way in and out till you figure out what you want. Usually, if you have the eyes, it gives you a really good starting point. as you can see here. It's not really super good. You see, that's one example of a starting point, is to start with the eyes. Another thing is you can start with a puppet skeleton, which is basically just an array of circles and triangles and boxes. And what it does is it allows you to make more dynamic poses. There may be a few pauses in the speech here. But something like this is a good start for a puppet skeleton. Now, if you're going for anthro characters, you need to remember where the ears are going to go in the tail. But I've pre-made a few drawings so to help understand, because I think either you or someone was asking about layers. So here's an example. For instance, here's as the start of a puppet skeleton for a more dynamic pose. And if you can see, you probably can't see, but this is layer one. The way layers work is, like in Photoshop, is you can work underneath a layer and still retain your one. Like, for example, I can scribble as much as I want on this, and I can just select it and the layer will go away, or I can select it and take away the top layer. Another good example of this is, here's a something I'm working on currently, and this is not one of my big projects, it's just personal work. Here's an example of the layers. For instance, the color layer is underneath the line art, and this really allows a good separation of things. Like, oh no, I've just lost my line art, or I want to do something different, you can start again and you still have your color, or I don't like the colors, get rid of it, and you still have your line art. And you also have like the base sketch underneath it. So anyway, back to the other thing. That's another video. It's like, for instance, we have this pose here. We have the puppet skeleton of these two characters. Now, after that, you kind of want to refine it. Kind of figure out what your shapes are. So you have this just basic pose. And it's like the shoulders and elbows. Now, at the same time, it's not still not very clear. So you take another layer and you go on top of it. Now, I have this rotated because I was working on something else. And then you have this. Here is a dynamic pose. Now, to me, the perfectionist I am, didn't really see a lot of what I wanted here. So I took another skeleton above that and gave it more of a curved look, more dynamic pose, and then worked it out, producing a new puppet skeleton. And this one kind of resulted in this, more of a dynamic pose, and we kind of have just a draft image here. So yeah, that's a good way to start with digital drawing. You can really just find your own way to start things, but this is how I usually start from the eyes, or I'll do a puppet skeleton. So I hope that answers your question, and we'll move on to the next thing.
So the third thing that we're going to do today is we have another comment off of DeviantArt from R*97. He says, "Wild Toaster!" And then he kind of does the X with the D, it looks like this. And he says, "Do you have some tips, advice on digital art? I really want to learn." So I'll give you a couple things that's helped me, and hopefully it'll help you too. So once again, I'll pull up my Photoshop and we'll start from there.
I'm going to just tell you a couple things that's helped me learn, and then maybe it'll help you learn as well. So one of the things that has really helped me is you need to observe. Observing just gives you a good idea about how things work. Just look at everything around you, be it the trees, be it the bugs, be it the animals. Just observe and see what they look like. So one thing I can tell you is to go to a park, go find yourself a bench, and sit down. Be sure to have a piece of paper too with you, and draw things. Observe. Another thing is to experiment. When you experiment, you kind of just get out of your comfort zone. Most of the time, it will probably end up looking like this. It's not good, but after a while, you'll just find different things. Like, let me see. Let me pull up my gallery, and I can give you good examples of that. I have never really drawn two things twice the same way. Here's a good way to start. Now, when I first started, I had a problem with noodle necks. Like you can see here, I had overly long necks. Eventually, I experimented where the necks would continuously get shorter and shorter to where they actually had a normal length. Here's one of those characters. It has more flow, it has a much different style than before, and even though it's the same character, it looks a lot better because most of this is experimenting. But if you see here, just go up a little bit further up, it's a whole different way of drawing him. That's the same character, but everything's different. Because you find faults and you correct them. And eventually you put them into Tron poster that takes you forever to make.
Alright guys, thanks for watching my video. Also for those who ask me questions such as Fiery Red Dog Techo, RStars97, and Jolton Thunderhead, I have a surprise for you. Hope you guys enjoy this.
Clothes like I didn't care. Hop in, take me any.